Tell me about this program.
So EXPLR is a streaming educational service founded by myself, Kari Byron, and Andrew Zimmern, who you might remember mm-hmm. from MSNBC, What's Eating America. Combined, we have 60 years experience in creating factual programming. So what we do is we provide under 10-minute video content to fill critical gaps in education, but to help kids understand how their education can be more real-world, relevant, and relatable. And the majority of our content is STEM-related.
I love that. And I love also that you have this new partnership with the Department of Education to create the You Belong in STEM Student Challenge. What is that?
Right. So EXPLR is running a national STEM challenge for grades 6 through 12, and we are tasking middle school and high schoolers with creating and innovating STEM projects that have the capability of solving global issues mm-hmm. Like future food, like health and medicine, climate, the climate emergency. They will submit these projects, so potential to change the world, but also positively impact people's communities and the planet.
I love it.
So we have a challenge, and then the top selected projects will get to come to DC for the National STEM Festival presented in partnership with the U.S. Department of Education.
I cannot wait to see what these young people come up with. Kari, I have little, so everything about science is fun to them. You know better than anyone, making science fun and engaging is crucial for programs like this, especially when you're talking about these groups, right? When you're talking about middle schoolers, about high schoolers, when you see the drop-off in STEM, how do you maintain that magic?
Well, for me, the way I maintain the magic is it's magical for me. The one thing that always made Mythbusters so successful was the fact that none of us were actually scientists. We were discovering along with the audience. So because I believe it's fun and the kids believe it's fun, we're all exploring this together. Science is just one of those things that once you get your hands dirty, it becomes more like art and playing than it actually is something you might just read in a book. And something like the National STEM Festival gives kids a chance to really, really put together projects that inspire them to create the next generation of solution makers.
I love it. I love the view from my kitchen where we're doing a lot of acid and base work to this idea that they're actually going to be students who are changing the world. You know, I think of you and the fact that you have spent your professional career doing this, and yet this is a very unique moment that we find ourselves in, right? Where just sort of the question of science or belief in science is somehow under question, is somehow up for debate. And so I wonder how you see young people, bringing young people into science as being critical always, but particularly critical in this moment.
Yeah. I mean, it's critical always for a few things. There's no debate that science is political. Every time you walk into the voting booth, STEM and science are on the ballot. We're voting for things like public infrastructure. We're voting for jobs bills. And a lot of times those are STEM related. So fostering kids' STEM understanding and STEM literacy just makes us better citizens. Where this gets dangerous is when science is used as anti-science to promote a political agenda. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what we're seeing a lot of right now. But this idea that science and politics shouldn't be together, they absolutely should, because it is critical for us to solve these big challenges that our nation faces, that our world faces.
I love the idea of just becoming yeah. a better, more astute citizen. Kari, I've got about a minute left. I wonder how you think national challenges like the STEM challenge can help open people's minds to the importance of not just science, but science education.
I've traveled all over the country with science-based television doing exciting things. And I can tell you, we all have more like than different. We all want to be solution makers. We all want to make a better future for our kids. So a challenge like this really inspires kids by giving them that catalyst moment where they feel like they can do this. They can have a career in STEM. They can move forward because we are honoring them and celebrating them.
That background makes me want to get involved in STEM. I only got about 10 seconds left. If people want to learn more, where do they go? What do they do?
NationalSTEMChallenge.com. Student submissions open October 4th.
My daughter is too young, but I know that she is at home copying down that URL. Jenny Buccos, Kari Byron, thank you both so much for spending some time with us.